Can we have the next question from the brother?
Hallelujah. I can ask for some question with you before I thankful Dr. Tun Mahathir because very nice opening the program. And also my High Commission Pakistan is here. And also I very respected. I am from Pakistan, Christian. My name is Yusuf Masih. And I want to talk with you Hindi and own language. Can you? नहीं आप दोनों में हिंदी बात करें तो बेहतर हो जाएगा।
I can understand Hindi, but all this audience majority will not. There are very few Pakistanis in India. So if you can't speak English,
because
speak in English.
I have a lot of question.
Ask one question, which is the most important.
But I want to ask with our language, easy for me and easy for you.
Okay, you ask in Hindi and because I translate into English.
Just now, one sister asked you some question.
You ask in Hindi, I will translate in English. Yes, brother.
Okay, मेरा पहला सवाल ये है कि मैं पाकिस्तान के स्कूलों में पढ़ता रहा हूँ और सलामिया दुनियाज सब कुछ पढ़ा मैंने, ठीक है। वहाँ पर हमारे टीचर थे कारी करामत साहब, तो अभी फौत हो गए, खुदा उनको जन्नत सेव करे। तो माँ किताबों में लिखा है कि नबी मोहम्मद सब नबियों के नूर हैं, ठीक है। दूसरी तरफ आपने काफ़ी प्रोग्राम आपने देखे हैं, मैंने आपके तो आपने हमेशा लफ्ज़ इस्तेमाल किया हसाई, हम हसाई नहीं हैं, ठीक है। बाइबल में आपने पढ़ा होगा, बाइबल में आपको लफ्ज़ असाई कभी नहीं मिलेगा, ठीक है, ये आपने नाम दिया है। दूसरा आप देखें जलाली किस नबी की पैदाइश, जो जलाली है।
भाई साहब कोऑर्डिनेटर ने कहा कि सवाल दो या तीन सेंटेंसेस में करो, उससे ज़्यादा करेंगे तो स्पीच हो जाएगा। आपका सवाल क्या, आप सवाल कीजिए, मैं जवाब दूंगा। दो या तीन सेंटेंसेस में आप सवाल कीजिए।
मैं भी आपकी तरह बढ़ना चाहता हूँ ना।
तो आप क्या कीजिए, हॉल हायर करो और पेपर में इश्तिहार दो कि मैं तकरीर करने वाला हूँ, जो आने के आएंगे
वही ना।
तो आज आपकी तकरीर सुनने के लिए लोग ने आए, तो ये सवाल जवाब का सेशन है। आप सवाल पीछे दो या तीन सेंटेंसेस में बस।
आप ये बता दें इन दोनों नबियों में जलाली पैदाइश दोनों में किसकी थी,
कौन से दो नबी में से?
नबी मोहम्मद और यसू अल मसीह में।
द ब्रदर आस्क्ड द क्वेश्चन, क्या बिटवीन मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम एंड बिटवीन जीसस क्राइस्ट पीस बी अपॉन हिम, who was more? Jalali can be translated into Jalali ka aapko ye bolo, who's better?
No, glory keh le,
glorious.
Jalali padesh keh sakte hain aap, behtar nahi. Aap dono mein ye bataye ki dono mein se sabki muqaddas, dono mein se muqaddas padesh kiski hai?
Brother asking a question that who was born better. Muqaddas padesh means who was born more pure. He is a Christian. He is asking a question, trying to lead me. And this Christian missionaries normally do. What is asking? Who was born more pure? Indicating that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born naturally. He had a mother and father. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, had a mother but no father. So normally Christian missionaries ask this question, which is beating around the bush, and then asking that Prophet Muhammad had a mother and father. Prophet Jesus had a mother but no father. So who's greater? Who's greater? The reply to this is given in the Quran in Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 59, which says, "Inna masala Isa inda Allahi ka masala Adam. Khalaqa min turab, summa qala lahu kun fayakun." The similitude of Jesus in the sight of Allah is the same as Adam, peace be upon him. He was created from dust and said, "Be," and it was. If he wants to say that Jesus Christ is superior, he is God because he was born without a father, then Adam, peace be upon him, is greater God. He had no mother and no father.
No. Adam ko Khuda ne banaya tha.
Bhai sahab, apne sawal puche, mera jawab suno abhi. Main jawab khatam nahi hua. Aapko lecture dene ka to hall hire ko ishtihar do. Ye lecture ka time nahi, ye sawal jawab ka time hai. Aap mera jawab suniye. If they say that Jesus is God because he had got no father, then Adam, peace be upon him, is greater God according to the Bible and the Quran because he had no mother and no father. So the reason is that Almighty God is the creator. He can create in different ways. Normal human being to born, you require mother and father. But Almighty God even can create without mother and father. That is Adam, peace be upon him. He can create with mother, without a father. That is Isa alayhi salam. With a man and without a female is Bibi Hawa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator. So just because Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, has no father, that does not make him God. If that is the case, then Adam, peace be upon him, is greater God, which Christians will never agree. So this is what Quran says. When you talk with the people, non-Muslim, تَعَلَوْا إِلَىٰ كَلِمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَكُمْ بَيْنَكُمْ come to common term as between us and you. So this is how Christian missionaries, they try and catch fish. They try and catch fish. They try and trap the Muslims by quoting from the Quran. And the Muslims who don't know comparative religion, they get trapped. If you hear my lecture, deceit in Christian evangelism. Deceit in Christian evangelism. How do they deceit the people with false things? And the trap is a full lecture of mine. That will give you how the Christian missionary try and catch fish. What we believe, we should not deceive anyone. We believe in haq. As I said in my talk, وَقُلْ جَعَ الْحَقْ وَزَاقَ الْبَاطِلْ إِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ قَانَ زَوْكَ when truth is held against falsehood, falsehood perishes. For falsehood is by its nature bound to perish. What Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, I want to tell you, brother, in the Gospel of John, chapter number 16, verse number 12 to 14, I have many things to say unto you, but he cannot bear them now. For he, when the Spirit of truth shall come, he shall guide you unto all truth. He shall not speak of himself. All that here shall he speak. So what we realize, your Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, spoke about the last and final messenger to come, and his name is Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him.
Okay.